lot of upper body strength, okay? The reason why it's upper body, you're not using your upper body all the time, but a lot of people do. You need your upper body to hold yourself up to make the transition, okay? But in the beginning, you can use something to sit on, right? As you can tell, your upper body is strong enough to hold you in this position, okay? You can use this to kind of simulate that. Now there's two techniques. It's called the J-hook, because it looks like a J. And the other one's called an S-hook. Now, the S-hook is way more secure. Let me show what I mean. So, I can hang here all day. My hand. Yeah. Because it's such a secure hook. The J-hook, it's quicker, but it's not as secure. I can myself slipping. Okay? So you kind of have to balance out quickness for more security. So let's start off with the easier one called the J-hook.
This here's the J. The J is easier.
No, this is the easier one.
Yeah, J is?
Yeah, the J is. This is J-hook, so this is easier. So what I want you to do is sit on here. I want to squeeze the rope in between your feet like this, right? And hold on to the rope. Butt off until you're basically off the board and you should point your own weight, okay? Now the technique here is this. Just like on the wall, if you're straight up and down, it's a lot of gravity pulling you down, right? But if you're at an angle, less gravity is the walk. So if I'm straight up and down, I'm going to slide down even faster. If I'm at an angle, like this, less weight. Not as much weight to hold myself up. Okay, so you guys try that.
Can I get-